Friends, yesterday's lecture again was to be deleted due to network issue. So this is again the repetition of yesterday's lecture itself. So we are continuing. Yes. In yesterday's lecture, the total things which we have discussed, I will again discuss this today as nothing was visible in that lecture. Okay, no problem. Now friends, day before yesterday's lecture which I have uploaded, in that lecture I have completed type 9, type 10 and type 11. So friends, small sums are over. Now we are going for the next chapter's topic, but the base is in the first chapter. The sums which are remaining in the first chapter are not expected in the exam. So that sums are not to be done. Now I am going for the base concepts which are to be learned in this chapter and may be used in the next chapters. Okay? Okay, starting from starting. Final accounts. We learned these final accounts in standard 11. And when we learned these things, we had trading account, profit and loss account, and we had a balance sheet. And these things are for sole owner. One. These final accounts are prepared, trading P&L and balance sheet are prepared for sole means one owner. In that, from trading account, if the total of credit side is more and debit side there will be balance, then that is gross profit. It will shown on debit side in trading account, and this gross profit will be transferred to P&L account credit side because here it is debit. In the same way, the trading account itself, if the debit side is more than credit side, there will be gross loss. Gross loss will be transferred to the debit side because in trading account it is on debit side. In the same way, in P&L account, when credit side is more and debit side is balanced, then that is net profit, and it is to be transferred in the balance sheet. And in the same way, if debit is more than credit, then there will be net loss and it will be transferred to balance sheet. Now these are the final accounts for sole owner, means one owner. But in standard 12 we are learning final accounts for partnership firm. You don't have to write these things in your notebook, friends. Just I am explaining the concept of the next chapter. 2-3 lectures we are just explaining these concepts. Okay? Please listen carefully. Now for partnership, as I said in the starting of the chapter, we have extra accounts. Means first is trading account with same rules. Next is profit loss account. Now the third one is profit and loss appropriation account. Fourth is capital account, but it has two types: fluctuating capital and fixed capital. Now if we are preparing the accounts to fluctuating capital, then only single account is to be prepared, that is partners capital account. And if we are having with fixed capital, then we need to prepare two accounts: partners capital account and partners current account. And the last will be balance sheet. Friends, this is standard 11's concept. This is standard 12's concept. There will be slight change. Trading P&L balance sheet for one owner, and all the calculations of capital are shown in the balance sheet itself. But when we are having more than one partner, then all the calculations are shown in this capital account and directly the balance is transferred to the balance sheet. So trading account, profit and loss appropriation account, partners capital account with two methods, and lastly the balance sheet. in detail, we are studying these profit and loss, appropriation and capital accounts. In that also, first I will explain, there are two methods. I have already explained this, I am just repeating. In the starting of the chapter itself, I have explained. Fluctuating capital means the opening capital and the closing capital will not be same. So only single account is to be prepared, that is partner's capital account. And in the question also, the balance of partner's capital will only be given. So at that time, in final accounts, there are only five accounts: trading, profit and loss appropriation, and partner's capital and directly balance sheet. Now, if we are having fixed capital method, means the opening and closing capital are to be kept same, and all other transactions are transferred to current account, and in the question itself, the balance of capital and current both are. So at that time we have six accounts: trading, profit and loss appropriation, partner's capital, partner's current and balance sheet. So six accounts. So this is the base concept. Please try to understand. Okay? So this is the base concept. Now friends, as this base concept is there, now what are the transactions to be recorded in this account? Because we know about trading, we know about profit and loss, we know about balance sheet, but we do not know about this. So first I will say that both these accounts will have only such transactions which are between the partner and the partnership firm. Profit and loss appropriation and partner's capital will have only such accounts which are between partners and partnership. Okay, now we are looking to the format of these accounts. Please listen carefully. Okay. And suppose we have for capital account, we have just now only fluctuating capital account method. So for that we need only partners capital account. We do not need partners current account. Now for that, columns are date, particulars. Suppose we have two partners A, B. Again date, particulars A, B. Okay friends, now I am starting. Suppose in the question, the capital accounts are prepared by fluctuating capital, means only one capital account is required, current accounts balance is only not required. First you listen this thing, how this thing is done. Okay. Now, P&L appropriation, profit and loss appropriation account is the third account, means before it there are two accounts. So how we are starting this appropriation account? After closing trading account, we have gross profit or gross loss. After closing profit and loss account, if we have on the debit side net profit, then it will come here in the next account. So we will write by net profit. As we are doing it from the trading account, if we have gross profit, then we are transferring it to P&L account, credit side net profit. So in the same way, in the P&L account, if we had net profit, then it is transferred here, and in bracket you will write from P&L account. and instead you have net loss on the credit side, so you will have on the next account debit side to net loss from P&L. These things are learned in detail in next chapter. Just now we only understood. Then friends, I would like to say that capital accounts balance will be given. And remember, always the balance of capital account is credit. So we are starting with the credit side, first day of the year, by balance brought down, opening balance, and it will be always on credit side, opening balance. Okay. Now, what are the transactions which are occurring during the year? Suppose you are having additional capital. And again, I will try to repeat that if in the question, when we are solving the final accounts, if it is given in trial balance, then only one effect. If it is given in adjustment, then two effects. So these all things are just one times. Now, again in the trial balance, only this thing is given, so one effect. Additional capital is brought by partner. Capital has credit balance, so additional capital will also have credit balance. So on the credit side, date can be any. What we will write by cash or bank or asset account. And what is this? Additional capital can be brought by A and B both or by any one of them. So additional capital is also shown like capital on the credit side, and it is in the trial balance or single effect. Okay. And it can be brought by cash or by bank or by asset. Next. Now, if we are having drawings for the partner, then drawings are having debit balance in the trial balance itself. Only one effect is required on the debit side of capital account to drawings account. Debt can be any drawings. Okay, friends. These are the transactions which are having only single effect, as they all are given in the trial balance itself. Opening balance, additional capital, and drawings. Drawings are debit balance or debit side. These both are written in the credit side of trial balance or credit side. Okay. Now, friends, about the adjustment I am talking. Now, if in the adjustment, if it is given interest on capital, then in standard 11th, you all know the two effects of interest on capital, profit and loss, debit side, and add to the capital format. But in standard 12th, we have different thing. Because we are having capital account, so interest on capital will be calculated how? Capital has credit balance, so interest on capital will also be shown here, credit side, and the last day of the year, which is 31st March, by interest on capital. Percentage we will take for opening balance and for additional capital if it is given, otherwise directly of opening balance. If 10% is given, take 10%. Capital is on credit side, so interest on capital will also be on credit side. Now friends, as this is an adjustment, it will have second effect. Instead of writing in P&L account in standard 11th, in standard 12th, we will write in P&L appropriation, budget side. Interest here is shown on credit side, so it will have debit effect here. So on the debit side, to interest on capital, partner A, B, both interest personal and total interest personal. So first adjustment, interest on capital. Capital is credit side, so interest on capital will also be on credit side. So if I am asking this question to you personally, two effects of interest on capital, then what you will say? Credit side of capital account and debit side of P&L appropriation account. Okay. In the same way, opposite to it, interest on drawings. Drawings are on debit side, so here interest on drawings will also be on credit side. If it is debit side here, then it will be credit side. Okay. So on last day of the year, 31st March, to interest on drawings for both partners. And again, there if it is credit debited, so here it will be credited by interest on drawings, partner A, partner B, total is outside. So two adjustments are over. Interest on drawings. Drawings are debit, so interest on drawing will also be debit. If it is here debit, it will be credit. Then salary, bonus, commission, etc. to the partner. Only to the partner, no other person. If to other person it is given, then we know it is shown in the P&L account itself, but here we are talking about only P&L appropriation. So salary, bonus, commission, which are to be given to the partner is an expense, so show it here. Two, salary, bonus, commission to partner, A, B, total is outside. Again, if it is debited, then here it will be credited by salary, bonus, commission to partner. Interest on capital and drawings are easy. Where capital is shown credit, so interest on capital credit here will be debit. Interest on drawings are debit, so interest on drawing will also be debit. If it is debited, it will be credit. Salary, bonus, commission to partner is an expense, so it will be debited here, it will be credited. Now one more thing which is not related to partner but related to profit, that is transfer to reserve. So when we are transferring the amount from profit to reserve, it is again a type of expense to transfer to reserve, and the next effect will be given in balance sheet. I am writing bracket balance sheet, so here it will not be shown. So that's all with the transactions. Now friends, whenever we are, first we need to close this, whenever we are making total, and if the balance is on debit side, then it will be called divisible profit. Which type of profit? Divisible profit. In standard 11th, when we are closing trading account, then we are getting gross profit. When we are closing P&L account, then we are getting net profit, and the next effect is shown. And in the same way, when we are closing P&L appropriation account, we are getting divisible profit. That profit is divisible means divided between two partners. In which ratio? In P&L ratio. And suppose if there is no profit, then here it will be loss. So by divisible loss, partner A, partner B, and in again P&L ratio. Now friends, profit is on debit side, so in capital account it will be credited. By divisible profit, and loss will be debited. To divisible loss. Now we are closing capital account. It is fixed that always capital account will have the totals more on credit side. So on debit side only it will be balanced. To balance carried down, closing capital. But friends, one more thing in the closing balance. Whenever the closing balance is coming on the debit side, actually it is which balance? It is credit balance, and credit balance is directly transferred to the balance sheet. So that's all about the two new accounts, profit and loss account and partner's capital account. When we are having fluctuating capital method, first you see how I have written that whenever we are having only capital account, no current account, then what all the transactions we need to learn? We have started with this profits or losses. This is the third account, this is the fourth account. So in the third account, if we had profit, in the second account, if we had net profit, then there it will be debited, here it will be credited from P&L. And there if on credit side we have net loss, then here debit side we will have net loss and from P&L account. Then here, capital accounts will have always opening balance as credit side. If additional capital is brought, it is like capital itself, so on credit side. Then drawings are debit balance, so it is shown on debit side. Now we are talking about the adjustments. Interest on capital. Capital is credit, so interest on capital also will be credit. If it is credited here, it will be debited here. Interest on drawings. If it is debited here, drawings, then interest on drawings will also be debited. If it is debited here, it will be credited. Then salary, bonus, commission to partner. They are expense of the business, so debit side, salary, bonus, commission. And if it is debited, it will be credited here. Then, if we need to transfer some amount to reserve before closing the profit, then first transfer to reserve and directly showing the balance sheet, not in the partners. And if ratio is not given, then divisible profit is debited, so here it will be credited. In the same way, if debit is more than credit side, there will be balance, that is divisible loss. Again in P&L ratio, if it is credited here, it will be debited here. After doing all these transactions, we are closing the capital accounts. Always the credit side will be more and debit side will be balanced, and that debit side balance is known as credit balance, and it will be transferred to the balance sheet. That's all. Very easy things. If you are having the concept of standard 11th, friends, then I am personally guaranteeing to each and everyone that you are understanding these things very properly. Okay. Now, we are talking about the second method, that is fixed capital method, and only I need to understand, I need you to understand one thing only, that only these three transactions will be shown in capital account, all other transaction will be transferred to the current account. Means the transaction which I have tick marked, these are shown in capital account itself, other all transactions are deleted and shown in the current account itself. So again, once more we will draw the whole format and we will understand it through fixed capital method. This was fluctuating. Profit and loss, appropriation account. Now, for capital accounts, now we have fixed capital method. And in fixed capital method, we require two accounts, that is partners capital account, which will have debt, particulars A, B, debt, particulars A, B. Very short account, because the transactions are being limited here. And one more extra account is required, that is partners current debt, particulars A, B, debt, particulars A. When we are having in the question both balance, that is capital's balance, current's balance, then we are preparing both accounts, and this is fixed capital method where we have two accounts. Previous method was fluctuating capital with only one account. Okay? And one more thing. This will have permanent transactions. Means capital will not change every year. And this will have yearly transactions, means all the adjustments are recorded here. Now, again from the starting, we are starting. This is third account, this is fourth, and this is now fifth, so balance sheet will be sixth. Okay. Now, previous to this account, there was P&L account, and if there is net profit on the debit side, we will have it on credit side. By net profit from P&L account, and here. And if on the credit side we have net loss, it will be shown here. to net loss from P&L account and here. In the same way, in the question, it will be given opening balance of capital and it will be always credit. So we are showing it on the credit side on first, fourth, by balance brought down, opening balance. Now friends, for the current account, it is dependent on the question. It can have debit and credit balance both. Now, why it can have, I will give the reason. Capital is such a thing which remains permanent in the business. Current is such a thing. In bank also we have savings account, current account and a fixed deposit account. Where current account balance changes every day, because every day, day-to-day transactions, we need current account. Savings account and fixed deposit accounts will not change after some time. Okay? So current account, if debit balance is given, then on debit side, and if it is given credit balance, then on credit side. So both sides it will be recorded. To balance brought down, opening balance debit here, and here by balance brought down, opening balance here, credit balance. So current account has a choice. It can have opening debit balance or opening credit balance. In the same way, it can have closing also credit and closing also debit. In the same way, capital account only has only one credit. Yes. Now friends, again in the question, in the trial balance, if additional capital is given, then that is permanent, additional capital. So, like capital account, like capital, it will be shown in capital account itself by cash, by bank or asset account. Now this is additional capital. That can be any. Again in the question, drawings are given. Now drawings will have debit balance, but friends, don't make a mistake, not in the capital account. Now all the transactions will be recorded in current account, because drawings are yearly. These all are permanent. So opening capital and additional capital only will be shown in capital account, other all things in current account. Date can be any two drawings account of A. Now friends, talking about all the adjustments. First we are talking about interest on capital. So interest on capital is just like a capital. Capital is credit, so interest on capital is credit, but not in capital account, in current account, because capital is permanent but its interest is yearly. So don't forget, when we are having two accounts, interest on capital will be shown in current account, not the capital. So on the last date itself, 31/3, by interest on capital, and as we know, if it is credited, it will be debited. Here there will be no change, here there will be slight change, because this interest on capital drawings are all yearly transactions, so only should be shown in current, not in the capital. Okay. Here, to interest on capital of A of B. In the same way, interest on drawings. Drawings are debit, its interest is also debit, 31/3. To interest on drawings, if it is debited, it will be credited here like previous only, but the change is of current account by interest on drawings, A, B. Now again the same thing, salary, bonus, commission to the party. It is the expense of the business, so debit side to salary, bonus, commission to partner, A, B. Again, if it is debited, it will be credited here, not here. Again, on 31/3, by salary, bonus, commission to partner. Okay. Again, transfer to reserve, as we all know, differentiating from profit. So, to transfer to reserve account, and second effect will be balanced, not here. So this much transactions were in the previous explanation also. When I was transactions were there. Now first you all look the difference. Here there is no difference, friends. Only the difference here is that opening capital and additional capital are permanent, so it will be in capital account. Whereas interest on capital, salary, bonus, commission, drawings, interest on drawings are not permanent, so it will be shown in current account. All other transactions in current account is. Now friends, here we have two more extra adjustments. That is interest on current account. And why two adjustments? Because current account can have debit balance, current account can have credit balance. First, I am talking about current account's credit balance. So, interest on current debit balance of current account and interest on credit balance of current account. As we have seen, interest on capital and interest on drawings, it is just the same thing only. Current account debit balance is here, so its interest will also be here. Just like drawings, if drawings are debited, interest on drawings is also debited. In the same way, opening balance of current account is debited, its interest will also be debited. So what I will write? To interest on debit balance of current account. And I will take the percentage from here itself for me. Now if it is debited, so it will be credited like interest on drawings, but interest on debit balance of current account, that is for A, for B. But don't get confused here, let it be debit. On debit side then debit, then don't write here credit, okay? In the same way, interest on credit balance of current account. First, show here credit side. By interest on credit balance of current account, and percentage should be taken from here. Now, if it is credited here, it should be debited. To interest on credit balance of current account A, B. Okay friends, these are the transactions. Now again the transactions are over. Now I am closing. Suppose if credit side is more, then here debit side it will be to divisible profit A, B. The profit will be distributed in P&L ratio. Now if the profit is debit, here it will be credit in current account itself. By divisible profit. Again, if debit side is more, then credit side will have by divisible loss A, B in P&L. Now we are closing capital account. Again, balance will be on debit side itself. To balance carried down, closing balance. Now closing balance is on debit side, so it is called credit balance. This you all need to remember, that if the closing balance is on debit side, then it is credit balance. Now for current account, again it is depending. If the credit side is more and balance is on debit side, suppose if the credit side is more than the credit side, then balance will be here. To balance carried down, closing balance, but which type of balance? It is debit balance, okay? Sorry, not debit, it is credit balance. Again, I will repeat. If the credit side is more than debit side, then debit side will have balance and it is credit balance. And in the same way, debit side are more than credit side, we will have balance. By balance carried down, closing balance, and it will be debit balance. Friends, this is all about the explanation of profit and loss appropriation, partners capital, partners current, in fixed capital and fluctuating capital, both I have completed. Now from this, what you need to learn is that, friends, different types of adjustments are learned from here. Adjustment number one, interest. We will see this in detail in the next chapter, but for instance we are learning it here. Suppose if I am telling interest on capital, then what you will give the answer? It will be, as capital is credited, what you will give the answer? On credit side of capital or current? If we are preparing capital, then credit side of capital. If we are preparing capital and current both, then current account credit side. So first effect is credit side of capital or current account and debit side of P&L appropriation account. Again I am repeating, interest on capital. Where it is shown interest on capital? On credit side of capital or current, and debit side of P&L appropriation. When there is only capital account, it is on capital account. When there is capital and current both, then credit side of current. Okay? Okay. In the same way, interest on drawings, if I am asking, then what you will give the answer? On debit side of capital or current and credit side of P&L appropriation. In the same way, the next adjustment is salary bonus commission to partner. Yes, it is an expense. Debit side of P&L appropriation, credit side of capital or current. In the same way, transfer to general reserve, debit side of P&L appropriation account and other is liability side of balance sheet. Here I am writing only balance sheet. Then next, interest on debit balance of current account. Debit balance means first start from here. Now here there is no choice, credit, current or capital. Here just you will say debit side of current account, credit side of appropriation account. And in the same way, interest on credit balance of current account, credit side of current account and debit side of P&L appropriation account. Then divisible profit will be, here will be debited, there will be credited. Divisible loss, here it will be credited, there will be debited. Capital will have only credit balance, whereas current account can have credit or debit balance in the opening and closing. That's all. Please watch this thing 2 or 3 times for the next chapter, otherwise you will not get these things. First, what I explained about profit and loss and capital account only. But in the second method, what I explained, P&L appropriation, capital and current both. When only capital account is there, all these transactions are here. When capital and current both are there, then these 3 are here, all other are here. That's all. Please watch it once or twice, then you decide you are understanding or not. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.